Hi everyone. So for today, I'm going to be testing out the new Voluminous Lash Paradise liquid eyeliners. I have both shades. One is rose gold, one is black. I'm gonna test out these today and see what they are made of. So I bought these because I love the mascara version of three. I love that. So I thought I'd wanna try these, but I haven't heard anyone talk about these really. So I bought them and I already have some opinions about them, but I'm gonna demonstrate them, like swatch them for you guys, show you how they apply and all that, and then give you guys my opinion. So first off, we have the black, which this is what the applicator looks like. You guys can see that. It's just a felt tip, it's not brush, it's just a felt tip. And it's pretty dark. They're not matte when they dry. They're like a satin matte. If that makes sense. Cause like there's a matte tone to it, but it's definitely not matte, but it's not shimmery or metallic either. One thing I will say, cause like you can see the little tiny brush marks, you don't get that much like product on the brush. So you have to keep going back in and digging over and over, which that for me is annoying, but that's just one thing. And then you have to put a lot of pressure to get any like true color, like the black. You have to put a lot of pressure on like the surface that you're trying to get this on. You have to put a lot of pressure to get anything, which when you want like a wing, I feel like you do the pressure here and then you kind of flick. With this, you can't exactly do that. The easiest, you have to, there's a learning curve to it. I'll show you guys. But then the other one is the rose gold. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's just a rose gold version of it, which I thought was really pretty. And it is really pretty, but I feel like maybe on either like super fair skin or deeper skin, this would be really pretty. Because on my skin, it almost blends in, like if you can see, there's four swatches right there, but it kind of blends in. But once it's in the light, it's really pretty, right? So I don't know, there's a lot of pros and cons of these. There's a little clicker, not clicker, but a little shaky thing in there. But I'm gonna show you guys how they apply. I'm gonna do one on one eye, one on the other eye. I did my eye makeup. I don't know if this is the best look for the rose gold version, but I'm still gonna give it a try. And then I'm gonna show you guys, hopefully it'll do what it did when I tried it before. And then I'll show you guys up close, but I'm gonna apply this one. So I'm to the black one on the right, my right ear as is left, I think. I'm gonna attempt to a wing. I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna attempt to do a wing. Okay, so I did back in once, because I did the straight across, and I'm gonna do the wing part. You guys can see, like real close, there's a patch right there, but there's no more product on this. I just dipped back. So it's just, this thing does not hold very much product, like at all, which isn't a huge deal. Just more of an annoying thing than anything, for me at least. Some people may not care, but for me, when I'm doing a line, like my wing liner like this, I don't wanna have to keep dipping back. I feel like you have to, cause you put it in there and it doesn't go all the way down, so you have to like twist it to make sure it gets the product. That's what I feel like you have to do. I don't know. But almost done with this. So, there's the one. It is. Okay, it is pretty. And I do like what I noticed when I swatched them on the back of my hand when I first bought these. I did them, and once they completely dried, I remember I took a bath, I did like my day stuff, and by the end of the day, they were still there. And I don't know, that's, for me, that's rare. But like the ones on the back of my hand right here, so they're not really going anywhere. So it's like once they dry, they're locked in, which is really good. It's just I like the packaging. Okay, I like the packaging, that's cute, it's kind of sleek. But something about the applicator and the formula, I don't know, I don't like something about that. But I'm gonna do the rose gold on the side now. And again, you may not be able to see this the best. I'm hoping you can. Where you can see it's really shiny, that's where it's at. But when I get to the darker parts, like out here where I smoked out the shadow, that's where I'm gonna really be able to see it. Okay, so that is both of them on. I don't know if you guys can tell. I'm gonna look real close for a minute. Yeah, and this side, it's not the easiest to see, but you can see it like clearly right there. But I like the idea. I think the idea of having a rose gold liner is really pretty and neat. It's just not as opaque and like pigmented as I'd hoped that it would be for a shade that is so pretty. Because if it was more pigmented, like had more opacity, I think it'd be really, really pretty. I mean, this is pretty, but it's not like anything crazy, I don't feel like. The black side is your normal black liner. I don't know if you guys will be able to tell on camera or anything, but it's on there. It might look matte. I don't know if you guys will be able to tell if that does anything more. Okay, it's definitely not matte, but it's not shimmery to me. It's not matte at all. So if you like matte liners, I would not recommend this one. But if you don't mind like a hint, like a satin, that's kind of like what it is, because there's not shimmer in it, it's not glittery, it's not shiny, but it's not flat matte, which I think kind of is good, because sometimes whenever they are super matte, they can be a bit dry. So I like this one, but if you guys can tell, right in the center, right there, slightly bled up, and then right here, I don't know if this is gonna show, but right there, my shadow. I did this last time where parts of the liner kind of blend in with my shadow and just make a dark patch. Last time it was way worse, so this time, I mean, it's a plus for this time. I like this one. This one is it's a really unique shade. It does work, if you can see. I mean, it's harder to see, but against a black, like a darker eye, it works. This one, I wouldn't recommend this one. This one, maybe, if you don't have anything like this and you just want to give it a try. This one, I wouldn't, because this, I think it's like $8, $9, somewhere around there. It's not bad. But one that works a lot better is this one from e.l.f., which is the, it's just the jet black liquid liner. This one works so much better. It's like $3 or something like that. So I can't really find a reason why I don't want to buy this one over this, when this one I feel like works better. And you don't have to keep dipping in over and over and over. I don't know. I don't foresee myself ever using this in the future. This one, the rose gold, I can see myself using this one with, like, as I said, like a dark eye. I thought maybe like all one color, like all brown, then do this. I think that might be pretty. But the black one, I don't recommend at all. This one, I would say give it a try. Or, yeah, I said give this one a try over both. This one for sure. But I can say that these are extremely long wearing, because I have worn this one before in the past. And they don't, for me, they didn't smudge, they didn't crease, they didn't flake, nothing. They wore perfectly. So in that aspect, they're really good. I just, the formula and applicator is what kind of boils it down for me, that I don't really care for this one. But I can almost overlook it for the color of this one. But if I found another one with a better applicator and formula, I'd definitely switch. But this one, it's not bad, it's just not what I would think would be, considering the mascara is such a hit that I thought for sure that that would be like amazing. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down below. Have you guys tried these before? What do you guys think of them? Is there a certain way you gotta use them to make them work for you? Or, cause mine always bleeds right there. I don't know if you can see it where it's darker right there. It blends into my shadow and then it just makes a dark patch. I don't understand that, but if you guys tried this, please let me know what you guys' thoughts are. Because for me, I don't care for the black one. I'm just saying, I don't like it, like, at all. Actually, the gold one, or rose gold, I don't mind it. I can overlook it. The formula applicator, I don't like at all. That one, I don't understand it. Just not for me. But the color, I love. And once it's on, it's really pretty. It's just not the easiest to work with. And it's just, I don't know, more hassle than I guess it's worth, is what I'm trying to say. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed, please hit the thumbs up button and let me know down below what you guys want to see next. And if you've tried these, please let me know. See like what you guys think of them or anything like that. I'm curious. But thank you guys so much. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Check my channel for my other videos if you're interested. And yeah.